Hey everybody, welcome back to the channel. We're hopping into the next episode of Community. This is season number 3, episode 16, titled Virtual Systems Analysis, or if you're a cultured person, Virtual Systems Analysis. So, last episode was, I'm just going to dub it the Britta episode. It actually kind of like, it flipped me a little bit, just because I was like, you know, Britta's an interesting character. And it actually kind of got me like reflecting about her and kind of thinking about why she does certain things, you know, at least in the past. So I really commend that episode for kind of like, I don't want to say like masquerading like as a comedy, but kind of like digging deep down into who she is as a person, because it seems like masquerading just seems like kind of like a deflection, but they very much purposefully crafted that narrative to be that way, and I really enjoyed that. And it looks like we're going to be taking the Britta Troy angle somewhere. Jeff Annie is now being herded another direction as well. So I can't wait to see where we go with those two relationships. And for those of you who are like watching this and realizing, hey, what the hell? Yes, I'm positioning things differently in my room right now. Big things are coming. But so far we're just kind of like reorganizing some things. So this won't be permanent. Things definitely change all the time. It's just the way things are. As far as this episode goes, I saw the thumbnail has something to do with Troy and Abed, naturally, for virtual systems analysis. We're going to see what that's about. I'm guessing, I don't know, technology, computer class, maybe, there's an app. I don't know. Either way, I'm guessing Abed's going to like take charge and steer this narrative, but let's just find out together. But before I do want to remind you guys, if you guys want to avoid the YouTube highlights and watch this episode with me in its entirety, that option is available for you right now over on Patreon. Links in the description down below or pinned in the top comment. If you can't support me on Patreon, you can always support me right here on YouTube. All you gotta do is drop a like, comment down below which one you want to see me react to next, subscribe if you haven't already, it's free, and of course, share it with your friends. Helps you, helps me, helps the channel grow. Everybody wins in the end. That being said, let's stop talking. Let's hop into this episode and talk about Amelia afterwards. All right, guys. Like, comment, share, and subscribe, and here we go.
We are so screwed. How are we gonna memorize all this?
Let's just go over it again. Kingdom, phylum.
Why do we always end up in this position? For all the time you spend here, you'd think we wouldn't have to cram so much.
Maybe we never get any work done because we have so much money now together.
Definitely, maybe that's why.
Uh-huh. Annie loves this.
I'm dressed this way because I have good news and bad news.
You have got to be kidding me.
Biology class is canceled. Bam. Oh, after yes. You. What a gentleman.
3-hour lunch.
3 hours? I could watch the first half of 3 movies.
First half of 3 movies.
If we don't eat, we can make believe a whole episode's worth of Inspector Spacetime in the Dreamatorium.
Word.
Yeah.
Maybe we should go to Senior Kevin's.
I can't go to Senior Kevin's. The manager and I are enemies. He said Die Hard was bad.
I know, buddy.
What?
Troy, Britta, you go to Senior Kevin's. Abed promised he'd show me how the Dreamatorium works. Today's the perfect day.
Oh, okay. She's playing Cupid, I see.
I am Inspector Spacetime.
Oh my.
And I know that, which is unknown. Geneva, I need the quantum spanner, the big one.
Oi, governor. Spanner, open that a minute.
Why are you talking like that? At least we're getting a Dreamatorium episode.
That sticky wicket.
Oh my god.
Okay, stop simulation.
More British?
I can't do this anymore.
But the blogons might intercept.
It's blorgons with an R. Blogon means thank you and blorgon.
Duh.
You're mad at me for playing matchmaker with Troy and Britta.
I'm not petty, Annie. I'm mad at you because you tampered with the fabric of the group. I run the scenarios. I examine this stuff from every conceivable angle.
Oh, and you can do that, but I can't?
Oh shit, she's got a point, actually.
Much like myself, the Dreamatorium has higher functions. Okay. Execute simulation, Troy/Britta, render
get
environment,
that. What?
Tenants.
No way.
I guess that explains why you never see any two of them on the same table.
So I guess
Annie's pretty hot to get us together.
She probably just doesn't understand people.
I like the way they're doing this. This is really cool.
I can't wait to get home to Abed.
So you can dart back and forth doing impressions of your friends. There's no science at work here.
Yeah. I want to see Annie's take. What's Annie's take?
This is the Dreamatorium's engine. My thoughts are collected by this box, and everything I know about my friends is stored here. I'm able to simulate any of the study group, and even a half-accurate Chang in over 7,000 unique situations.
It's cardboard tubes and a funnel.
You see it that way because it's calibrated to a specific level of brain function.
Gee, you've got it all figured out. King of toilet paper rolls over here.
King of toilet paper rolls.
Hey, Troy. Your lunch is going well, right?
Yeah, just checking in on Abed, making sure he's okay.
Oh, my.
What?
Just, you know, make sure he stays comfortable. I worry about him when I'm not around.
Troy, do you want to get laid or not? What the fuck?
And another thing I hate about Die Hard.
Oh, so you're actually like this?
I have a better idea. You know what would make your scenarios a lot more realistic? From now on, before you do or say anything, you're going to think about how it affects the people around you.
Look at him. He's like, error. Oh my Jesus.
Hello, Annie.
Oh, is this cool, Abed?
Were we doing it?
Oh.
Being Jeff?
Well, I'm not being a Kardashian.
Make love to me, Anne. I know I'm just a surgeon and you're a hotshot upstart administrator, but damn the rules, damn the system, damn our 2 foot height disparity. I want you.
Later. Bye.
I kind of wanted to see how it was going to play out. Yeah.
Can you please tell me where I can find Abed? I owe him an apology.
Abed? Never heard of him.
I asked you a question, Doctor.
I'm a surgeon!
And I'm your administrator. Now tell me what I want to know, or God is my witness, I'll have your stethoscope.
Fine. Dr. Perry might know.
Britta?
Look, there's Britta and Troy fooling around with each other.
Look, there's Abed having overcome his issues.
Nice try.
Now we're going to kiss.
This is what you think I want? What do you want, administrator? I want to talk to Abed.
There's no one here by that name.
You're lying.
Yeah, you killed Abed.
Sodium pentothal, known commonly as truth serum.
I saw Abed's name in the hospital school files. I love butt stuff. I hate spiders. I stole a pen from the bank. I cried during About a Boy. I didn't get Inception.
Maybe Betty White can explain it to you.
Oh.
You said you saw his name in the files.
There's so many layers.
Right. Render environment, medical study room.
Jeff, get the files.
Why me?
Because you can see the cabinets. And I'll make love to you.
Jackpot.
Damn.
There is an Abed in this hospital school. But he's not a doctor.
Jeff, take me to Abed.
Now where is that?
Enough games. Just take me where I want to go.
Follow me.
Not to your bedroom.
Are we close?
Almost there. Although you should probably run in place and let the hallway move around you. Here we are.
It's this moment! No. Really?
Here. Then I would.
Season one!
Whose memory is this?
Maybe it's yours. Maybe the Dreamatorium really works.
Jeff, Abed, stop. I don't want to do this.
No!
You've thought of everything, Annie. There's nothing standing in the way of us.
What?
Come on. This is your dream. This is why you played matchmaker.
Yeah.
You are not Jeff. Because Jeff cares about Abed. And we are not here. And I'm not staying here because I hate whoever you are.
Damn.
Storm off in.
I want to be alone.
Execute simulation. Annie/Annie.
Two Annies?
Why are you blowing our magic moment with Jeff? It's not magic. It's not even real. We love Jeff. No, we don't.
Wait, what?
Just in love with the idea of being loved. We keep running the same scenario over and over, hoping for a different result. Running scenarios? Careful now. You're starting to sound like Abed.
Starting to sound crazy. Or isn't that insanity?
Star Wars. Zardoz. Cougar Town. Cool. Stop it. Pop culture.
Oh, smart.
You're gonna get in trouble.
Meta.
I got an Abed here! Get him!
That's it. I find you guilty of being Abed.
Oh my god, what the... This is insanity.
This time you'll never get out. Abed?
Inspector Space-Time?
Tell me where we are so I can pretend to see it.
We're inside a locker. It's where I spent a lot of time in junior high.
Aww.
You think this is where we'd put you? You know that's absurd, right?
Well, I'm not stupid. You can see I've increased the square footage. It's a metaphorical locker. It's a place where people like me get put when everyone's finally fed up with us.
I've run the simulations, Annie. I don't get married. I don't invent a $1 billion website that helps people have sex. I don't make it into Sundance, Slam Dance, or Dance Pants. Troy invents Dance Pants in 2019. Don't tell him. He needs to stumble onto it.
Did that happen?
The scenarios you run in here are like great science fiction, but they're not accurate for crap. Science fiction never has been. Look at 2001. Did we have a space odyssey? My point is, your simulations are nothing more than anxieties. You're afraid you don't fit in. You're afraid you'll be alone. And you'll always fit in. I was trying to make life go according to some script. I can't. You can't.
Wow, this is some quality-ass writing right here.
It would cut down my dreamatorium time by 18 hours a week. I'd take up yoga.
You have the body type.
I'd be down for a...
These fake shackles don't have a fake...
Any yoga episode.
Quantum spammers for?
Technically, no. But that's fine.
He's back.
So, should we get back to lunch?
I guess so. A little more anticlimactic than I would have simulated it, but whatever.
Inspector! Set the tachyon drive to hyperjump! We must get to the other side of this starfield before the Blorgons intercept!
She said it right!
Blorgons, in this sector? Well, this mission has gone pear-shaped indeed. Our quanta blasters are useless against their armor. We're as cooked as Lord Nelson's mutton, we are.
Not if I can help it. Take that, Blorgons!
Brenna and Troy walking in together.
Sounds like this has been a game-changing day for all of us. I almost sat on my balls.
Good job, man.
Good job, man.
Sorry I bailed on the dreamatorium.
It's okay. Annie did pretty good in a pinch.
Maybe after a long, dark night, the sun is starting to rise on Greendale.
Maybe. Maybe not. You never can tell what kind of day you're going to have.
Okay, I didn't really avoid sitting on them.
You did sit on
right on them.
Oh!
Yes, I'm sorry.
Hurt like hell. I saw eagles.
I have a little surprise for you. I did a little extreme bedroom makeover.
Oh, they don't like it.
It's okay, buddy. We can put it back. We can put it back the way it was.
Okay, guys, so that was season 3, episode 16 of Community, Virtual Systems Anal Sys. Wow, season 3 is knocking it out of the park, you guys. And I just want to just make a mention of something. Between this episode and last episode, I really liked how we kind of tackled the more human concepts of everything. Like, we kind of dug deep in with our characters. And last time we kind of took a focus on Britta. This time we took a focus on Abed, and I really like what we had to say. I mean, every time we kind of put Abed in this situation, I always kind of feel bad because it's always like he's excluded. He's not like everybody else. He's such an honest and sympathetic character. So I naturally feel bad every time he's, you know, kind of shoved aside or whatever. But I liked how we kind of got our final. How we finally got our dreamatorium episode. I've been waiting for that ever since they kind of introduced that that concept. And I had a blast with it. I love, because I do watch Doctor Who. At least I did. I think I stopped after Matt Smith. I got a little bit into the Doctor after Smith. But I love the concept of Doctor Who. I thought Smith and Amy Pond were my favorite Doctor and companion. So that's what I was kind of seeing with Abed and Annie. I was just kind of just imprinting their image of Matt Smith and Amy Pond over them, and I had a blast watching all that. I love the developments we got with Troy and Britta. I like the kind of self-reflection we got between Annie and Abed, who was posing as Jeff, trying to kind of coerce Annie into realizing this is what she wants, but then she kind of realized that you're not Jeff, you're Abed. You know, it was just like a big roundabout way to kind of like air out the dirty laundry, I guess. You know, to kind of put everybody out on notice, what our characters are actually thinking about, in kind of like a really fun and neat way without being so forced or, you know, just pigeonholing, oh, by the way, I'm feeling like saying stuff like no person talks about. But when you have a concept episode like this, where you can kind of play around with certain ideas and you kind of see their memories and their feelings kind of manifest in front of them, which is why I really liked the concept of the Dreamatorium episode. I loved it. I mean, some characters didn't really do much, you know, like Shirley, which is kind of sucks that Shirley is always kind of like, you know, pushed to the back more often than not. But when she does, you know, come to play, she hits it out of the park because she's a hard hitter. Don't fuck with Big Cheddar, you know, because she don't play around. But this, along with last episode, I just love the pairing. It just feels like, I don't know, like, it almost feels like a two-parter, but not really. It's just that these two episodes kind of felt very similar, but they were executed differently. There's almost like focusing on certain aspects of, like, I don't know, human emotion. I don't know if I'm just looking way too far into this or if it was purposefully done this way, but I really enjoyed what they did. I think the writing was incredible. I think the situational awareness and execution and everything, it just felt so real. And of course, you kind of, you know, contrast that with the Dreamatorium, the wacky stuff, but it all works out in the end. So I really enjoyed this episode. I thought it was just as good, if not better than the last episode, just because I'm my bias for, you know, I like Ovid a lot, but last episode, Britta really, like, stole the show, and I kind of was, like, hoping we got a little bit more Britta in this episode, just a little bit. But, yeah, I can't wait to see what happens next, guys. Season 3 is, like, 10 out of 10 so far. I mean, at least for me, personally. Because I haven't hated any episode so far of Season 3. I think every episode I've been, like, praising it, round of applause and everything like that. But, yeah, I think I'm just going to end it there, guys. Really good episode. Can't wait for the next one. But, till then, all right, guys, if you guys enjoyed my review, enjoyed my reaction, you guys want to see the video with me in its entirety, that option is available to you right now over on Patreon. Links are in the description down below or pinned in the top comment. If you can't support me on Patreon, you can always support me right here on YouTube. All you got to do is drop a like, comment down below what you want to see me react to next, subscribe if you haven't already. It's free, and of course, share it with your friends. Helps you, helps me, helps the channel grow. Everybody wins in the end. Until next time, I'll see you in the next episode of Community, which will be Season 3, Episode 17. One step closer to the finale, and yeah, until then, like, comment, share, and subscribe, and adios.
And if you liked what you saw, tell your friends, tell your family, tweet about it, and if you didn't like it, shut the fuck up.